It is the book of John, of course. We go back to where we left off. And we will look at the sixth chapter and we'll look at the 16th verse, where we will see and learn lessons from Jesus. We will let Jesus teach us this morning. We will get our lesson directly from him. In the sixth chapter of John, the 16th verse, you will find these words. And when evening was now come, his disciples went down unto the sea and entered into a ship and went over the sea toward Capernaum. And it was now dark, and Jesus was not yet come to them. And the sea arose by reason of a great wind that blew. So when they had rowed about 5 or 20 or 30 furlongs, they see Jesus walking on the sea and drawing nigh unto the ship. And they were afraid. But he said unto them, "It is I. Be not afraid." Then they willingly received him into the ship, and immediately the ship was at the land whither it went. Now, if you will, turn to the sixth chapter of Mark, because in the sixth chapter of Mark, we have the same story. Only Mark gives us a little bit more information. In Mark 6 and 44, we discover that these disciples did not decide to go over to the other side of the sea on their own. It is recorded here in Mark 6, 44, 45, pardon me, that Jesus constrained his disciples to get into the ship and go to the other side. In other words, what this text says is that literally Jesus forced his disciples to get in the ship to go over on the other side. And these disciples, being obedient to the master, they got on board and began to row across the sea in obedience. And in the midst of their obedience, there was a great storm that arose. And the winds began to blow. And remember, Jesus is not in the ship. And the winds began to beat over against that ship. And because of this, I thought it would be a good idea to learn what we can learn about what Jesus is doing here. And the first thing that I see, church, that is going on, that I hope that you can see, and that is that Jesus allows his people here to experience something, to come face to face with a storm alone. He's teaching them what it's like to operate without him. And so he commands them to go over into the ship, and as they're rowing, and by the way, it's important to understand that these disciples were in their strength. They were in their competence. Somebody say amen. Amen. These were fishermen. These were men who knew the sea. They were sea tested. They understood about the sea. But Jesus put them in a storm where he was not there. And they found out with all of their ingenuity and with all of their ability and all of their competence, they could not make it without Jesus. My friends, I want you to know that you can know that or you can experience it. You got a choice. That you can know that you can't make it without him, or you will have to experience it so you can know that you cannot make it without him. And my friends, there are certain things that you don't have to experience. Just do what he says. These disciples had to learn by experience. The children of Israel had to learn by experience. You do know that the children of Israel traveled in the wilderness for 40 years to reach a destination that it only really took 11 days walking. Because God had to give them the experience. You do know the prodigal son had to eat from the husk of the pig. Because he did not trust his father. He did not trust his father's judgment. And because he did not trust his father's judgment, he said, give me my possession. He went out to a far country and ran into a citizen there, and he lost all he had. I wish I had somebody here that knew the Bible. He lost all he had. And the Bible says that the world, young people, didn't give him a thing. No man. I wish somebody would say something. This man went out. Where my amen folk at? This man went out into the world thinking that the world was going to be his friend. And in the end, the Bible said that the world didn't give him a thing. But he had to experience it because he wouldn't listen. And it was in the hog pen that he came to himself. Young people, you don't have to go to the hog pen. Some of you in here right now, you don't have to experience what drugs are like in order to stay away from it. You don't have to know what crack will do to you by experience it. All you got to do is listen to somebody else's testimony. Amen. Am I right about it, somebody? You got to go through. You got to go. Just as there's some people in here right now that'll tell you what that's like. I said, you're too quiet in here right now. I said, there's some folk in here right now that can wave their hand and tell you don't use crack. And listen, I'm not trying to embarrass anybody. What I'm trying to do is get you to give your testimony. Because that's where the power is. You can save somebody if you got enough nerve to tell the folk what the Lord has done for you. Am I right about it, somebody? You ain't got to be a dropout to know that you need an education. Am I right about it? Am I right about it? Am I right about it? You don't have to go to jail, young people, in order to know that jail ain't the place you ought to be. There's somebody in here right now that has already been to jail. Am I right about it, somebody? Do yourself a favor. Just do what he says. Don't try to experience it. But then, this is the first thing that we learn here in the text. But the second thing we learn in the text is there are times when you do what he says and you get in trouble. That's the other side of it. That there's always trouble associated with obeying God in this cruel world. My God, I wish somebody would say something. That you will experience pain and heartache and trial and tribulation and disillusionment and confusion. You will experience all of that doing what Jesus says.